Hello, everyone. This is Jake, your resident content cowboy here. Yeehaw! And I'm back with another Pokemon Unite guide. The best builds for Lucario. I would say there are really only two builds for Lucario, and if I'm being honest, I think one is far, far superior. We're gonna go over it in this guide. We'll have gameplay, we'll go through his moves, we'll go through held items and battle items, and at the same time, we'll become better friends. That's right, you and I are friends now. I hope you like someone asking you for money. By the way, can I have some money? I'll pay you on Friday. Well, not this Friday, the next. I'll pay you on Friday of next month. Okay, let's talk Lucario. Lucario's difficulty is expert, and I totally agree. This is the Pokemon I've had the most trouble with. Gengar was a little tough to figure out, but when I first started playing Lucario, I was terrible with Lucario. And it's just because I didn't understand how to combo with him. Lucario is all about the combo. If you figure out Lucario's combo, all of a sudden, you feel unbeatable. Let's take a look at his moveset. At level 1 and 3, you get Quick Attack and Meteor Mash, whichever one you'd like to choose. I think Quick Attack is a better one to start with, just so you can disengage. Meteor Mash is really great, and I love using it early to push opposing Pokemon into a direction they don't want to go. But where it really starts to open up is level 5. You choose between Extreme Speed and Power Up Punch. Both are good. One is better. Let's talk about Extreme Speed. You charge forward with a dash move. If it hits an opposing Pokemon from point blank range, its cooldowns reset and it restores your HP. It's actually really good. I like this move a lot. I use it sometimes when I'm playing Lucario in lane. It also increases attack for a short time once it levels up at level 11, but it's just not Power Up Punch. I know, I don't know what to say. I just think Power Up Punch is better. So Power Up Punch, you charge power before you dash forward, but while you're charging, your movement speed goes down, your attack speed starts to increase, and then the damage you receive is reduced. So you kind of become a little tank as you're like charging up. By the way, that's a great charging up sound. That's mine, nobody can steal that. Is mine. You then dash to the enemy Pokemon, you hit them with the move. The lower their HP, the more damage it does, so it picks people off so well, and then your next basic attack is a boosted attack. You immediately charge in, and then immediately spam your attack, and then you will use your next move. Also, the cooldown is then reduced if the next move hits. It's just, this combo is too good. You've got to use power. I love Power Up Punch. Here in 1 minute, I'm actually gonna show you exactly how this combo works, but we'll just quickly talk about Bone Rush. Bone Rush is what you wanna pair it with. You perform a combo attack with a bone, you basically hit people at close range and throw a bone out in front of you. You use the ability again and you dash to that bone and you deal damage to everyone around you. Also, its ability at level 13 resets the cooldown of Extreme Speed or Power Up Punch, so you will then power up your punch again and hit them into a combo attack. Let me show you how this works. You charge up your Power Up Punch and you just let it get past that little line. It doesn't matter how much past it. Then you immediately attack with a boosted attack. You go to your Bone Club and then boom, another Power Up Punch. Right there, you do thousands of points of damage in that one little combo. It's so brutal. Oh, look at it go. This is just too brutal. In my opinion, this is why you play Lucario, this entire moveset right here. Something to notice also, you want to charge this past the line, but everything past the line is the same amount of damage, at least as far as I can tell. So as long as you get past that little line right there, you're good. Your Power Up Punch is charged up. If you do it under that little line, it doesn't do as much damage. You can use it as a fast escape, which is, you know, nice sometimes. But in general, you're going to want to charge up past the line. As you can see there, it does a lot less when you don't charge it up. Also something to keep in mind, if you charge it all the way up, and don't use it, it goes on a brief cooldown, so use it. It's not the same as a full cooldown if you actually use the move, but it's a brief cooldown, I think 1 or 2 seconds. Back to his moveset, you have Close Combat as another option for an attack. It's, in my opinion, not very good. It does deal a lot of damage, but it's so easy for enemies to avoid. It's harder to hit than most things. This just is not ideal, in my opinion. I'm sure there's someone out there who has a great build and they swear by it. But as far as I'm concerned, Lucario is all about the punch and bone rush, baby. Even Lucario's Unite move powers up their next power-up punch. It increases the damage of it. So I just feel like this whole kit is based around this one combo. I've used Extreme Speed and I actually really liked it. It's just not this combo. This combo is everything. If I go to McDonald's, this is the combo I order. And they say, sir, we don't have that. And I say, check again. And they say, actually, we were wrong. We do have this combo because this is the best Lucario combo. Let's talk about Lucario's passive here. When a Pokemon's at low HP, you get a shield and its movement speed is increased. It's nice. It just kind of pops in a fight, or when a couple people are chasing you down, you can get away and you can also turn things around really quickly. Basic attack becomes a boosted with every third attack. It also becomes boosted after power-up punch every single time. It deals area damage and it's really, really good. Oh, this combo. I'm just freaking out about it. I gotta go to McDonald's on the way home. Battle items. As always, this is up to you. Personal preference, I think, is best. I love eject button. I also think slow smoke is pretty good for Lucario. I've done it a couple times. Fluffy tail is very specific but usable. So is X attack. And I just had someone in a comment mention that they really love running potions. So whatever floats your boat. For me, it's the eject button. I don't have these held items upgraded, and ideally you would want them upgraded, but I think this is a good kit for someone like Lucario. Float Stone just helps you get to people a little faster. Scope Lens, of course, is giving you that critical hit rate. And Muscle Band, I think, is good for lots of Pokemon. You can look through some of the recommended kits. I don't love a lot of them, but that's kind of interesting, actually. Oh, maybe I would try that one. All right. Some of these are pretty fun. Also, if you've watched some of my other videos, you know that I love Shell Bell. So I do rock Shell Bell on Lucario in place of the crit item just because I have not upgraded my crit item yet. Sorry. I don't have $1 million. So let's take a look at some of this here in action. This is early, but I grabbed Extreme Speed in this match. And I love this little combo of Extreme Speed and Meteor Mash early. I'm just using it to block this Snorlax. He's gonna try to go home, but I'm not gonna let him go home. No, sir. Again, not my preference, but I do think Extreme Speed is pretty fun and pretty useful. If it comboed with his other abilities better, I would probably have a build where I ran Extreme Speed. This match I was laning. A lot of times I lane with Lucario. Sometimes I get to go jungle. I think he's amazing in the jungle, but I figured I would try the Extreme Speed close combat combination, and I'll tell you what, I did not like it. Extreme speed, still pretty good. I just wouldn't take close combat next time. At least I would do extreme speed and the bone club. Did I just call it the bone club? I meant bone rush. Boy, they both sound weird, huh? Dude, I'm on a bone rush. Ooh, or even something like, Diane, I know you've been cheating on me. Someone told me you were at the bone club last night. All right, enough jokes. Here is me in a situation using a Unite move into a power-up punch and just, whew, you get rid of everybody. I swear, you gotta go with the combo. Power-up punch, bone rush. It is a must. Here's some footage of that combo in action. This was a match I got to jungle. You just dash in with that power-up punch and me and Haunter do some work. Oh, too good. Here we have a pretty wild team fight that I initiate with my Unite move, and then I miss my Bone Rush, unfortunately. Pull back in to fight, power up punch. Oh, Cinderace is gonna get me. I'm running. Boom, power up punch, and I finish him. Whoa, what a move. I'm not embarrassed to say it. I'm on a Bone Rush, baby. Lucario's getting me on a Bone Rush. So there you have it, the best build for Lucario. I honestly don't think it's close. I think this really is the best build. Bone Rush, Power Up Punch. I think Extreme Speed is good, but it's not this good. Let me know what you think in the comments. Are you on a Bone Rush because of this? Thank you all for watching. Thank you for listening. Let me know what guide you'd like to see next. I have more coming. I'm trying to get through everyone as fast as I can. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for listening. If you like what I'm doing here, a subscribe would be great. And of course, I'm your good friend, so please, I need some money, okay? Look, I hate having to ask you, but what am I gonna do, huh? I'm going to be out on the street. Bye, everybody.